Welcome all of you on behalf of Indian Meteorological Society Pune Chapter and Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology. Today we have gathered here to listen a very important and very interesting lecture under the Professor T.R. Pisharoty Distinguished Lecture Series. Actually, this lecture series has been introduced 12 years back, and this is the 12th Professor T.R. Pisharoty Distinguished Lecture to be delivered by Shri Ashish Lahiri. He is a writer, translator, lexicographer, and researcher in the history of science, specializing in science culture, visiting faculty of IISER, Kolkata, and member of Pavlov Institute, Kolkata. So he will be giving a very important talk on the works and life of Sri Radhanath, Sikdar, a pioneer Indian meteorologist of 19th century who measured the height of Mount Everest. You are doing science nowadays with a lot of facilities. But 200 years back, there was no such facility, and it was under the British rule. And in British rule, somebody actually measuring the highest peak of the world, it was a very astonishing and very, at the present moment, he could have got Padma Shri or Padma Bhushan or even maybe Bharat Ratna also. But at that time, there was no such facility, so that's why his name was obscured in the history. So I actually, we are specially interested to put these persons, India, has given, and this type of persons who has done lot of works, and it could have been for other countries, it would have been a glorious thing. So for our country also, we feel that it is a glory of our country, Mr. Radhanath Sikdar. So about the Radhanath Sikdar, it will be, lecture will be given. So on the talk, his talk will be based on the life and works of Sri Radhanath Sikdar, a pioneer Indian meteorologist of 19th century who measured the height of Mount Everest, the highest peak of this world. So this actually lecture is organized by IITM and IMSP together. So we are jointly organizing, and I will now invite our speaker, Sri Ashish Lahiri, to kindly come to the dais. Please give a big hand to him. Sir, please. Our director, Professor Ravi Ranjan Nanyundeya, is always supportive to IITM, and he has given all kind of support for this, all IITM, IMSP efforts and activities. I welcome Professor Nanyundeya on the stage. Dr. R.R. Kelkar is a very known face, and he has been the Director General of Meteorology of Indian Meteorological Department for a long time, and he will also have a brief introduction about Radhanath Sikdar. So I will be welcoming him, sir, kindly please. Now I will request our President, our Chairman, Dr. J.R. Kulkarni, to kindly come into the dais and take his seat. So this actually lecture is under Professor T.R. Pisharoty, who has been the first founder director of IITM. So I will be requesting our present director, Professor Ravi Shankar Nanyuda, to kindly give a brief address about the Professor T.R. Pisharoty lecture series and Professor Pisharoty's life. And
of an interaction with him, but I did have one interaction which was very important for me in my life. He was my thesis examiner, and he did a thorough job of it, and even at the age, I guess at that time he was pushing 80, and then he looked through almost every line of the thesis and made comments on it, and his comments were very useful for me to improve my thesis. So I'm ever grateful for him for his help that he gave for my thesis. So just I'll give a brief overview of this very illustrious person. Professor Pisharoty, the father of Indian remote sensing program, a distinguished meteorologist and a space scientist of international repute, was born on 10th February 1909 at Kollangode, Palghat district of Kerala. Starting with his early education in Kerala, Professor Pisharoty had a brilliant academic career in Tiruchirappalli and Chennai, Bangalore and Los Angeles, and worked with Nobel laureates such as Sir C.V. Raman at the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. He began his professional career as a lecturer in Loyola College, Chennai in 1935, and later joined as a senior professor officer in the India Meteorological Services in 1942, where he there conducted research on thunderstorms, western disturbances, monsoon depressions, orographic rain, etc., amongst many other interests that he had. Professor Pisharoty then joined the University of California, where he came in close contact with world-renowned meteorologists like Jacques Holmby, Jules Charney, Neil Berger, Yale Mintz, Vertule, etc. And he did quite some heartbreaking work when he was there at the University of California. During this time, he was engaged in investigations of the atmospheric general circulation and published two reports entitled Some Aspects of Geostrophic Poleward Flux of Sensible Heat and the Kinetic Energy of the Atmosphere. These are questions that we are still researching on even today. After obtaining his MS and PhD degrees in 1954, he returned to India. Professor Pisharoty was the director of the Kolaba Observatory in Mumbai during 1959 to 1962, and also directed the International Indian Ocean Expedition Program in 1961-62. He became the founder director of the Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Pune, now which we know our institute as the Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, or IITM, which was founded in 1962 and was instrumental in nurturing the institute in its formative years. Following his retirement from IITM in February 1967, Professor Pisharoty was invited by Professor K.R. Ramanathan and Dr. Vikram Sarabhai as a senior professor of aeronomy at the Physical Research Laboratory, that is PRL, at Ahmedabad. At this point, he was instrumental in introducing remote sensing technology to India. His pioneering experiment of detection of coconut wilt-root disease using Soviet aircraft and US equipment was considered to be one of the first successes in remote sensing in India for its application. Professor Pisharoty served as the director of remote sensing and satellite meteorology at the ISRO's Space Application Center in Ahmedabad from 72 to 75. He was a member of the Scientific Advisory Board of World Meteorological Organization from 1963 to 68, and later its chairman. He also served as the vice president of the International Association of Meteorology and Atmospheric Science, and as an executive member of the Joint Organizing Committee for Global Atmospheric Research Program from 1969 to 1977. He worked at PRL until the early 90s, when he retired for health reasons. Professor Pisharoty contributed to a good number of research papers in national and international journals, and wrote a number of books on Indian monsoon and other related topics. Professor Pisharoty was elected a Fellow of the Indian Academy of Sciences in 1957 and a Fellow of the Indian National Science Academy in 1978. In recognition of his contributions, he was awarded the prestigious Padma Shri Award of the Indian government in 1970. He was the first recipient of the Raman Centenary Medal in 1988. He was awarded the IMO Prize by WMO in 1989. He was also conferred in K.R. Ramanathan Medal, established by INSA in 1990. He died on the morning of September 24, 2002 at Pune at the age of 93. Pisharoty continues to remain as a major source of inspiration for many young meteorologists and will be fondly remembered for his inimitable style of inaugurating science in scientific meetings, seminars and symposia with invocation of Sanskrit verses and explaining their meanings very carefully. he was, I mean, that was always something which we always looked forward to when Dr. Pisharoty was around. And without further ado, I, with this brief introduction about Professor Pisharoty, I request Mr. Mahapatra to continue with the program.
Thank you very much, sir, for kindly giving the details of Professor Pisharoty, and he has been our former director and also the founder director of IITM. Now I'll be giving a brief about our today's speaker, Sri Ashish Lahiri. Mr. Ashish Lahiri is a writer, translator, lexicographer, and a researcher in the history of science, specializing in science culture. He is a visiting faculty of IISER Kolkata and member of Pavlov Institute Kolkata. Mr. Ashish Lahiri is a very well-known writer, translator, lexicographer, and then also a researcher in the history of science. He conducted research on Radhanath Sikdar and the colonial science under the history of science in the Indian National Science Academy, INSA, New Delhi. And he has published several books, and we can have some books actually. After this lecture, you can see his books, and if somebody is interested, they also can take his book. So he actually taught history of science at the Asiatic Society Kolkata and the National Council of Science Museums. Currently, he is the visiting faculty of Indian Institute of Science, Education and Research, IISER, Kolkata. He is the best known as for the Bengali translation of J.D. Barnard's magnum opus, Science in History. He is the member of the Pavlov Institute, Kolkata, India. Mr. Lahiri has translated into Bengali the following books: Jack London's White Fang, J.D. Barnard's Science in History, Joseph Dunham's History and Human Values, Dorothy Crawford's Hodgkin's The Wandering Scientist, and Amartya Sen's, and our Nobel laureate Amartya Sen's, History and Human Values. Dorothy Crawford's Dawkins, all these books have been translated from different languages to Bengali. The Wandering Scientist, Amartya Sen's on interpreting India's past, Bipin Chandra's India after the independence, and Ramchandra Guha's India and Gandhi. All these actually books have been translated to Bengali so that it can come to the Bengali people very simple words. Now, some of his original Bangla publications include Philosophy of Science and Karl Popper, A Class of Two Paradigms, Vidyasagar and Vivekananda. They are the two great people of India. And Akshay Kumar Datta, Scholar Extraordinary. Then Theism, Atheism, Science and Society, Science and Ideology. Then Rabindranath Tagore's The Science and the Religion of Man. Tagore, The Science and the Religion of Man. Generally, we are knowing about him as the literature, but he has also said about Rabindranath Tagore as the science and the religious in his personality. Swami Vivekananda and Bengali secularist traditions. And From Tagore's Music to Tagore, A Personal Journey. Radhanath Sikdar, A Bicentennial Tribute. So he has given a tribute in that book, and he will be describing in his presentation about that. And then Science in Bengali, The Early Phase. And his English publications include Radhanath Sikdar, Beyond the Peak. Actually, this is the highest peak he has actually discovered. And then Science in the 19th Century Bengali, Caught Between Two Cultures, Radhanath Sikdar and Colonial Science. And he has also been involved in several dictionaries, every man's English Bengali dictionary. He was the co-editor. And some sort the English Bengali English dictionary, that he was co-editor, and junior translated illustrated dictionary, that was English to Bengali. And he has received several awards, including Brajendranath Bandopadhyay Puraskar for Bangla Sahitya Parishad in 2011, Ravindra Puraskar for Science Writing in Bangla in 2010, Ananda Puraskar in 2001, jointly with other editors for everyone's dictionary, English Bengali. This is the big biodata him. And actually yesterday when he was coming at the airport, he has got some small injury. And but still he was quite strong enough to come here. And he has visited our doctor also. And Dr. Mukhopadhyay and Mr. Kumar Roy have given a lot of support to him. Dr. Mukhopadhyay is actually coordinating his visit. And our IMSP people are also helping all these logistics with kind support of Director IITM. So I will now request our chairman, Dr. J.R. Kulkarni, kindly felicitate our speaker today. a brief introduction will be given by our guest, Dr. R. R. Kelkar, sir. And for that, actually, this we need that curtain to go now. So I will be requesting all the dignitaries to kindly take their seat in the front seats of this auditorium.
Good afternoon. This is a very brief introduction, just take a few minutes. We had long introduction to the speaker. This is slightly different. I'm talking about three eminent personalities today, Professor P. R. Pisharoty, in whose memory we are having this lecture. Mr. Ashish Lahiri, who is a distinguished speaker this evening, and Mr. Radhanath Sikdar, on whose life and works we are going to hear about today. We have just heard the complete biodata of Professor Pisharoty. He was born in 1909. He had a brilliant academic career. He worked with Sir C.V. Raman, none less than him, and Professor Jacob Birkenes at Los Angeles. And he got his doctorate from the University of California in 1954. He was a Sanskrit scholar. Most of his scientific lectures will begin with a shloka from some Sanskrit piece. He was a visionary and a great institution builder. He was the founding director of IITM, and after retirement, he joined the Physical Research Repository and came to be known as father of remote sensing in India. This was after he was 60. And later on, when he was much older, he was instrumental in the foundation of the National Center for Medium Range Weather Forecast. He himself had gone to Rajiv Gandhi and got a supercomputer for this country, along with the IMSP. It was my good fortune that in 1965, when I was just 21, I had reported to Professor Pisharoty as a young IMD recruit. He was the first person I had met in IMD, and it was a nice introduction and a nice way of receiving me into IMD. He said, "You're a young boy from the university. First thing you do is forget everything that you have learned and learn everything afresh. If you're doing research," he said, "we'll question everything. Nothing is to be taken at his face value." Much later, in 1991 to 93, he was the IMS president. He lived in Pune. I was the secretary in Delhi. And he used to, those days there was no email. So he used to send letters written by hand in beautiful handwriting. He would also write Sanskrit shlokas along with the letter that he used to write to me as the secretary. And he used to tell me that the more you write, the more your handwriting will be beautiful. So keep on writing by hand. He was my first, my chief, then my guide, then a philosopher friend, and a well-wisher. I'll just tell a couple of things that I would like to share with you. Professor Pisharoty was giving a lecture once to young people, and he said, I'll give an exercise. And he shocked everybody by giving that. He says, write your obituary. And people were shocked to hear that. He said, write your obituary, which you would like people to read when you are gone. And then live up to that expectation of people so that it will sound true. Otherwise, obituaries are usually not exactly true things. So he used to give advice like that to young people of a very different kind, and I had the good fortune of working with him and for him for a long time, even when I joined IMD when I was young. Professor Pisharoty was a director, and he used to take a round of the whole institute every morning to see if anybody needed anything. A simple thing like attendance register that he had to sign. He used to, do you have it? How long do you have to go? How far to sign it? And so next morning he'll bring the register to sign it. So he took care of each and everything. So today I pay him my humble tribute and come to the speaker. Mr. Lahiri, I have been having the pleasure of knowing him for many years. The last time was in Calcutta, I think 5 years back. You know, he's a very simple man, but an extremely learned man, an epitome of simple living, high thinking. And we were having dinner in a 5-star hotel, I remember that. And he chose the simplest of things.
Hindustan International
in Calcutta. It was a lavish dinner. And he chose the simplest of things from the menu for his dinner. And then asked him, where is your car? Where did you park it? He said, I came by a suburban train. So he's a simple man, but an extremely enlightened and a learned man. Born in 1948, spent his time in Kolkata. And he's a prolific writer. He's a teacher, translator, and lexicographer. A lexicographer is someone, see, people like us, we consult dictionaries. People like Mr. Lahiri, they compile dictionaries. A lexicographer is one who compiles dictionaries. So you can imagine what sort of a speaker we have today. He's associated with so many institutions, INSA, IISER, Asiatic Society, NCSS, and the Pavlov Institute. Pavlov Institute is an institute for physiological research of all things. I'd like to know what he does there, but that's what it is. So I meet him, and it's my pleasure to welcome him to the city of Pune. And hope to be in touch. Coming to the topic of today's lecture, in 1767, the British East India Company established what is called the Survey of India. And in 1802, they launched an ambitious project called the Great Trigonometric Survey. This was like a robber or a thief surveying his plunder and loot. To put it in very simple words, this is our country, which the British East India Company had plundered. And they launched a survey which had a scientific name called the Great Trigonometric Survey. And they wanted to see what they have really kind of collected from this country. And Radhanath, Sikdar was a mathematics student from Hindustan College, Hindu College, Calcutta. And he was given the job of a computer. In those days, 200 years, computer was not a machine but a human being. And the name of the post was computer. So the computer was one who computes. So there were no machines in those days. There were human beings who were actually posted as computers, and he had a mathematics background. So he was given the job when he was 19 years old. Before IMD was formed in 1875, there were lots of meteorologists in this country. There were officers of the British East India Company. There were doctors, engineers, astronomers, there were Christian missionaries. All of them had an interest in the weather. Henry Piddington was there in 1797 to 1858. He coined the word cyclone. He wrote books on cyclones. And James Prinsep of Banaras, he died in Calcutta. He was a British officer. And he took synoptic observations. This is all before IMD came. And Radhanath Sikdar was the first Indian meteorologist. The others were British. He was the first Indian to dive into this field. So in 1829, there was a office of the Survey General of India. They put up an observatory in Calcutta. And Radhanath Sikdar was promoted to the post of chief computer. So, and he was posted there as in charge of the observatory. And he introduced really very systematic things and published them. In 1852, Radhanath Sikdar spotted the highest mountain peak in the world. and reported its height of 29,000 feet to the Surveyor General. In 1855, people thought of checking what Sikdar had done, and they found that he was right. But they added 2 to it, just to make sure that it's a precise calculation, it was 29,002. Finally, it is now known as 29,029. But as usually happens, even today, the credit went to the boss. This is something which we have today also, that people work and the boss takes the credit. But the credit went to the Surveyor General, John Everest. He had retired by that time. And to honor him, Radhanath Sikdar's calculations were kind of credited to John Everest, the previous Surveyor General. What have we given to Radhanath Sikdar? 2 things so far. One is India Post has issued a postage stamp of 5 rupees in 2004. And in this city, in front of the General Post Office, on the sidewalk, there is a memorial to Radhanath Sikdar, which is very interesting because I don't know how many of you have seen this memorial. If you have not seen, please go to Pune GP and Cantonment to have a look. It's an open memorial on the sidewalk. People can read about it, they know who he was and what he did. So these 2 things only we have done, and Mr. Lahiri has published a book on Radhanath Sikdar. In fact, he made another book which he showed me. And he is going to tell us a lot. But I have 2 questions for the speaker before I close down. One is, doesn't Radhanath deserve a greater honor? This is my first question. And the second one, isn't it time now to rename Mount Everest? So this is something that I would like to ask the speaker to comment on. But can we not honor Radhanath with something higher than a postage stamp or a sidewalk memorial? And can we not rename Mount Everest? When things are being renamed everywhere, railway stations are being named every day, cities are being renamed, the states are being renamed, why not Mount Everest? With these questions, over to Mr. Lahiri. Thank you.